just wanted to include this little snippet for you and apologize. I am in my work uniform. I got back from a business function in Las Vegas just 2 days ago, and I got home from work today and started cooking everything in sight so I could get these videos into you. Nothing I'm not used to with the multitasking. I don't know if you can see it. MasterChef season 13 winner right there. But anyway, wanted to give a description on the pie that I'm making since there's no talking in that part of the video. And it is a chocolate haupia pie. In Hawaii, haupia is a type of sweetened coconut dessert. Kind of resembles a pudding, but a little bit more dense. So essentially, it is just a chocolate coconut pie. But disclaimer, you're gonna hear some loud booms and my dog barking. Those are not gunshots. Those are fireworks that my neighbor thought would be a great idea to set off as I was recording. So just wanted to throw that in there. Let me know if you have any requests or questions. Thank you.
Hi guys, I am going to julienne this carrot as requested. This is just one of the videos. And there we go, julienne. Okay, up next I am going to chop a red bell pepper as requested. There we have it. There's a chop for you. Next, I have some bok choy that I'm going to chiffonade as requested. There we go, chiffonade. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and pan sear my salmon skin on. I'm gonna go ahead and season the skinless side with some sea salt, some black pepper, and a little bit of cayenne. For the skin side, I am just going to use a little bit of sea salt. I'm getting my pan boiling, screaming hot, not boiling. It's been getting very hot. As you can see, it's steaming. So I'm gonna go in with a little bit of oil. And I'm gonna just lower my salmon down, skin side down. And I'm gonna hold this right where it needs to be until the skin starts to crisp up. I'll be here for a few minutes, so I will continue the video when I'm ready to flip. Okay, we're coming up on the 6 minute mark with my salmon skin, and it is looking like it's about ready to flip. Okay. Here we are. Use a couple minutes on the bottom side. I'll just show you. I don't know if you can hear that. Okay, I'm gonna finish the salmon and then I'll cut into it and show you what it looks like on the inside.
Thank you.
Okay, hollandaise sauce as requested. I have a lemon and I am going to just juice it in here. And then I'm going to show you my setup, because the whole point of me trying to win this thing is to show that humble home cooks from Hawaii, a lot of us who don't have fancy kitchen gadgets, that we can make something out of nothing. We can make anything, anything at all with what we have. So that's the idea behind it. And you'll see to my left, I have this semi-simmering pot of water, which is only filled about an inch of the way, an inch full of water in the pot. And I'm happy with just about a tablespoon of lemon juice there. I have a glass plate slash bowl because I don't have a stainless steel bowl, and it's just gonna go right over my pot, and making sure it's not too hot. And then I'm gonna go ahead and separate my four egg yolks. Put them in there one by one. This is very hard to do when I'm filming by myself because I don't have the assistance I need right now, but we're gonna make it work. Okay, it's whisking time. And I'm going to whisk this up a little bit. And I'm going to add my lemon juice and continue whisking. Is about a tablespoon there. Then I'm gonna go crazy whisking. I don't know, for the next 5 minutes maybe. See if I can give you guys a glimpse while I'm doing this. This is what we have going on. And again, that water is not boiling, not touching the bottom of the bowl, just barely simmering. Because I don't want to overcook my egg yolks. And hollandaise is something that I have made before, so I'm confident that it won't break. Just a workout. And once this doubles up a little and increases in volume, I'm going to come back and pour in my melted butter. So I'll be standing here whisking and I'll be right back. Okay, we've been whisking and whisking and I just spilt butter. Okay, so I have about a half a cup here. I'm gonna slowly, very slowly do this.
need to switch hands because my arm hurts. So far, so good. Just a lot of work. Just a normal day in my house. It can't be quiet in here. It just can't. I tried really hard to make sure that it was quiet for these videos, but 3 kids, 2 dogs, 3 birds. You're never gonna get that around here. So I only used about half my butter and I'm still going. Very slow process, making sure that this guy does not break on me. And I give these chefs credit. This is not for the faint of heart. Switching hands. Because I'm dying. And at this point, I've already turned off my stove because I don't want anything to get too hot and start cooking. I'm losing energy. Oh my goodness. We're almost there. I've almost doubled in volume. And I have the last of my butter about to go in a second. There we go. Just giving this a final whisk. And sprinkling in a dash of cayenne. And I know you need to add salt to this, but I don't necessarily like the hollandaise too salty. That makes sense, but I am going to pick this up and show you what we got. So, it did not break, even if we're using limited utensils. It is beautiful and creamy, and I am going to plate this with my salmon. Be right back. I figure I will show you the consistency from my hollandaise, which is beautifully creamy. Oops, this is hard to do with one hand. Mm-hmm. Okay, plating time. I am going to start off with a scoop of black rice. Right in the center of my plate. And I'm gonna try to make it as even as possible. And this is just gonna give my salmon some height. I'm gonna take my hollandaise I made earlier. And I'm going to go around the rice with the sauce. That up. Then I am going to take my salmon, crispy skin salmon, place this right on top, and I'm going to garnish it with the chiffonade I made earlier with the bok choy. And here we go. Still cooking that chicken. I'm gonna send some photos of this as well, but here it is.
Yep. Typical. Good.
getting a close-up? I needed only a close-up.